Andrew here, Sterilizer Autoclave Solutions, 704-966-1650, option 3 for free technical support. Okay, right now we will talk about weekly maintenance. My biggest pet peeve for anybody performing weekly maintenance is to drain the water weekly. We're empty right now, but basically you just take this tube, hold it down into a bucket. You got a little bit of water in there. Hold it down into a bucket and just drain it until it comes out, drain it till it's empty. And the more often you do that, the better off everything and everyone will be. Because if you just keep adding water on top of old water, so every day you come in and your water's down here in the red because you're running a lot of cycles, then you just add water and you do this month over month, year over year. It builds up a biofilm so deep, an inch deep inside of the bottom of your reservoir, that it'll take an army to clean it. So big pet peeve is draining your water weekly. It sounds like a lot, but it saves you a lot of money in the long run. Just a note is every 7 days, as long as the unit is plugged into a power source, the autoclave will automatically display perform weekly maintenance message. If the power is disconnected, the cycle of weekly messages will be reset. So as long as you plug this in every 7 days, it'll tell you to do your weekly maintenance, drain the autoclave or drain the water out. We're gonna look at the trays. We're gonna make sure nothing's on the trays. Make sure they're all nice and clean, free of rubber, paper, needle tips, anything and everything that could get left behind on trays. Make sure they're all fairly clean. You're gonna pull the rack and tray plate out, like so. Obviously, make sure that's clean. Now we can inspect the bottom of the chamber and make sure that you don't see any paper under there, any needle tips, any plastic, rubber, whatever you may be sterilizing, things, pieces break off, fall off. So you wanna keep an eye on that. Also, you got this chamber filter here. There's two of them, one's in the center, one's in the back middle to the left. You're gonna clean them with Speed Clean, a toothbrush, and some distilled water, and then just kind of pat them as dry as you can, or just rinse them out and put them back. You're good to go. They do kind of press in. Let's see, my baby, there we go. Okay. Then you also have your temp sensor in the back. That's in the middle, center, little probe sticking out. If you see any build up on that, you're gonna clean that with Speed Clean, an abrasive pad, and you're gonna wipe that dry. It shouldn't be bent. Sometimes it does get bent. It's not the end of the world. So you're gonna clean the filters, you're gonna clean the trays, and see if I missed anything. That's about it. I recommend highly that you're always draining the water out of these things, and that will keep your reservoir clean, it'll keep your chamber clean, it'll keep all your valves and filters clean. And it's a beautiful thing. So if you have any other questions, give us a call. If you like this video, please share it. Please subscribe to our channel, and please stay tuned for more Midmark M11/M9 troubleshooting videos.